Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, then my name is Hosanna, and on this channel we talk about tech, career and lifestyle. On today's video, we are going to be talking about tech certifications. I wanted to continue with the cloud computing series that I started off last week. That's because I got lots of positive feedback from you guys saying you found it really useful. I did a broad overview of cloud computing last time, but I really wanted to focus on certifications today, talk about what they are, how you get started, why you should do them, and all of that great stuff. If you like this type of content, then please, of course, like the video and subscribe so that I can continue to make videos like this for you guys. Tech certifications are essentially a non-degree award that's given to people who complete a specific course based on a subject. So for example, cloud computing. And within cloud computing, we have certifications for different areas. So for example, infrastructure or DevOps or analytics or cybersecurity. Tech certifications are usually role-based, which means that the information that you learn within the course will usually reflect the task which you'll have to perform in the job. For example, if you're interested in being an administrator, then you can take either the Azure or AWS Cloud Administrator exams. And for those courses, you'll be taught to do things like manage subscriptions, set up the networking, and of course, secure the environment. Usually the course that you do for certification will include written information for you to take in, but usually also some laboratory, so some hands-on stuff for you to practice the information that you're learning. Once you have completed the learning element of the certification, so you've done all of the studying on your course, you can then take the exam. The exam is usually about an hour long and can be done online and proctored as well. And once you finish the exam, you get a little badge which shows that you are officially certified, which you can share across all your social media, especially, and most importantly, I would say, LinkedIn. Certifications are really important within the cloud computing space now because over the last few years they've grown in massive popularity. So more and more employers now look for certifications in potential hires, but they also expect their current employees to become certified. More than ever now, certifications are seen by employers, hiring managers, and recruiters as essentially showing that you've got the skills to do the job. And it's kind of like a stamp of approval to show that you know what you are doing. And of course, certifications also show that you have up-to-date skills because often certifications expire about every 2 to 3 years, depending on the organization that you take the cert with. Therefore, certifications are a great way for you to increase your value to employers. And there are actually some really great statistics about the value of certifications out there. I've just read some amazing ones on a cloud guru, which if you're not convinced to take your certification seriously right now, you certainly will be after I read these out to you. So the first one is that 80% of people say a higher salary was a direct result of cloud certification. 52% say cloud certification expanded their career opportunities. And finally, $12,000 to $13,000 US dollars is the average raise IT professionals who've gained new skills and or certifications reported receiving. So that's really amazing. It really shows how much a certification can impact your career. I will say though that personally, I don't think certifications are a replacement to a degree, a bootcamp or experience. They're more there to boost everything that you already have and to boost your application and to prove that you've got those skills. So you can't just have a certification on your resume. You of course need to have other things like work experience, projects, bootcamps, degrees, as mentioned before. You guys will know that I'm currently working as an Azure Specialist at Microsoft, so my role focuses both on infrastructure and data and AI. Because I am in a technical sales role, I'm expected to have a pretty good understanding of my products, which means that I also have to take certifications. In fact, at Microsoft, pretty much every employee, even the ones who aren't in technical roles, are expected to at least do the Azure Fundamentals for certifications. So that just shows you how important certifications are, even for these big employers and for their internal employees as well. So when I started at Microsoft, I started off, of course, with the fundamentals, just like everybody else. It is the AZ-900. But then when I was looking to move into the Azure Specialist role, and to be honest, even when I was in my last role, I really wanted to just be more technically skilled. And when I decided that I was actually going to make the jump, about 6 months before, I decided to take my AZ-104 certification. So this is the Azure Administrator one. The reason why I decided to take them, I knew that it was going to be valuable for hiring managers, especially going into the Azure Specialist role. I knew how important that would be. I knew it would boost my application because my hiring managers would look at that and think, yeah, she's definitely got the technical ability to do this job, and we're not going to have to kind of push her. It's not going to be a big jump for her to come into a role where she hasn't really been doing things that are as technical in her last role. It took me about 4 months to study for the Azure Administrator exam. It is not an easy exam, guys. I will say that the jump between fundamentals, so that's the AZ-900, and Azure Administrator, which is the AZ-104, is quite high. So if you have a good understanding of cloud computing, what it is, the benefits, the risk, and all of that good stuff, I think the 900 will be easy for you to take. They will be okay. You'll have to do some studying to really understand kind of Azure itself and the portal and what it looks like, but nothing like the 104. It really took some time for me. Luckily we're during obviously the pandemic, so I wasn't traveling for work as much, so I had time, but I really did study every day after work and over the weekend as well, because I really wanted the certification, and I'm so glad I did, guys. I can't stress how glad I am, because when it came to interviewing for my new job, that was probably one of the first questions that I got. People were like, so what certifications do you have? So what level of Azure do you have? And pretty much every hiring manager asked me, and when I would say, I would be like, I've got my 104, don't worry. They would be like, yes, great. You know, that was one of the reasons I was actually hired. My manager said that, you know, having that on my resume really helped boost my application. I am now planning to focus on data and AI more and take certifications within that path. As I said earlier in the video, guys, certifications tend to be role-based. So because my role focuses on both infrastructure and data and AI, I want to start making the move to focus on some analytics, some machine learning certifications as well as kind of like core data ones, because I feel I've kind of reached my peak with infrastructure. I can go and do architects, but I don't think it'll be valuable for me right now. I think it'll be more valuable for me to kind of focus on down a different route. And I think that's really important to consider. Really think about where you would like to get started with your certifications and where you'd like to go. I think don't just jump in and just pick any. Really think about what role you'd like to do, because again, they're role-based, so there is a path. So now onto the good stuff. I'm going to now list some of the top certifications that there are out there. This is based both on kind of demand from employers and also the potential earnings that you could make from these certifications. The first set of certifications I definitely think you should have a look at if you're interested in cloud computing and you have the technical ability is the cloud architect ones, and that's across GCP, AWS, and of course Azure. These are definitely number one on the list, and that's because cloud architects are actually the highest earning roles within the cloud space. So in the US, cloud architects make an average of $140,000 a year. And in the UK, they make about $75,000. There's a difference because obviously the salaries in the US are much higher than here in the UK. But if you think that the average salary in the UK is about $30,000, a cloud architect makes over £30,000 more than that. So double the salary of the average person. So if you are definitely interested in cloud computing and looking for a role where you're going to make, then you should definitely consider looking at the cloud architect certifications. The GCP cloud architect certification is actually the highest earning one, which is great, even though GCP is actually the third highest cloud provider out of the other two. If you're interested in Google and want to work there, then you should definitely consider their cloud architect certification and get that dollar. The Microsoft Azure Cloud Architect Expert Certification is the next one, and it's actually considered one of the hardest ones for you to take. So the 303 and the 304, which is the exam code, are super difficult exams, which means though they are considered very in demand. In fact, a company called CIO stated that the Azure Cloud Certifications were actually the most in demand ones for 2021. So if you're willing and up for the challenge, then I would consider exploring Azure as well. Finally, the AWS Solutions Architect Associate Certification is actually the most popular certification for AWS, which means that it's popular all around, of course, because AWS have the highest market share for cloud. So if you are considering which one to go for and, you know, popularity is important for you, then also consider the AWS one. The next set of certifications I think you should have a look at if you're interested in cloud computing are the foundational ones. So that's the Azure Fundamentals by Microsoft and the Cloud Practitioner ones by AWS. I think these are great certifications for anyone who is just starting off with cloud computing. If you have little to no experience with either cloud providers, both of these certifications will really give you good knowledge. As I said, when I started at Microsoft straight out of university, everyone was kind of expected to take these certifications, the Azure Fundamentals one. It gives everybody a great basis of what cloud computing is, what are the benefits, what are the governance, things like that are important for you to have a stepping stone within cloud. The great thing about these certifications is that they're not as hard and they don't take as long to study for, and really anybody can do them. If you consider that the business side of tech companies, everybody on that side is able to take the certification, even the most non-technical person is able to take the certification, you definitely can too. So a great way to start. I think these are really good for anyone who is particularly wanting to go into cloud computing but doesn't necessarily want to be an architect or an engineer. So if you want to be, for example, in tech sales instead of kind of being the person that actually does the administrating or the architecting, then this is a great certification for you to look at because there's so many benefits to having the foundational knowledge of cloud computing. Finally, if you're looking for something that's vendor neutral, then I definitely think you should consider the CompTIA Cloud Plus certification. So this gives you basic knowledge across all of the cloud providers, so Google, Amazon, and of course Microsoft Azure as well. So if you're looking for something that's an overarching perspective of cloud computing and still gives you the technical knowledge, but you're not specific on which company you'd like to go for, then consider that certification. So the CompTIA Cloud Plus certification will test your knowledge on how to kind of manage resources within the cloud, security, networking. However, I will say that this is not a cloud beginner type of certification. It is recommended that you have about 2 to 3 years of experience before you try and dive into this certification. So it's for people who are a little bit more experienced. If that's you, then definitely check it out. Tech certifications can be quite expensive, guys. So they range from something like $99 all the way up into like $300 from what I've seen. So kind of be prepared to have to pay for that certification if you're doing it by yourself and your company isn't sponsoring it. Some cloud providers though, if not all, will have free certifications sometimes, maybe for their fundamentals exam, maybe if you go to a training day. I know that's for sure for Microsoft. So if you go to the Microsoft training day for Azure Fundamentals, Microsoft will fund the $99 for your examination. So make sure that you check that out, but just naturally look on the GCP website and the AWS website to check if they're offering something similar as well. So now I wanted to give you guys some tips on how you can get started with studying for your certifications. Like, I can definitely say it was very daunting when I had to study for mine, especially when you finish school already. So now to have to go back into the rhythm of kind of preparing for examinations, it's a little bit odd. But if you're looking to get into tech, that is something that you're going to have to get used to, guys. Tech is about continuous learning. So there will be more tests, there will be more exams down the road. So you just have to be prepared for it. So I kind of have 3 tips for getting started with studying for your certifications for you guys. So the first one is to know your learning style. Some people like to learn by watching videos and taking that information like that. Some people like to learn by reading. See, I'm definitely the watching. When I was studying for my certifications, I was on YouTube, I was on Pluralsight, I was on all the websites that gave me videos because I really can't stand having to dig information in written format. I don't know if that's just me or maybe I need to get that checked out, but I really can't do it. Even when I'm just like reading instructions or a manual for something, I have to watch a YouTube video. So knowing my learning style really helped with that because I just found tutors online that really helped me. The second tip that I have is to break it down, guys. This is a lot of information, especially if you're going for certifications which are high as the 304, 303 and are really difficult. It's going to be pages and pages, or kind of like notes and notes of information about the certification. So make sure that you break it down in manageable chunks. I know that all the cloud providers will have like training pages and landing pages, which breaks down the information on how you should take it in and takes you on a path. So I would definitely say check out their pages, but breaking it down helps to kind of retain the information and do it in a way that's kind of more suitable for you. The other tip that I have for you guys is look for mock exams. So you're probably going to find websites online, and I'll pop it in the description below, that are actually going to have mock exam and past examination questions for this. So this really helps, because obviously if you get to see the mock exam, one, hopefully one of the questions might come up in the exam, and two, it just prepares you for the start of questions. So the mistake a lot of people think when it comes to, I mean, any exam, is that they think it's going to be like, what is Azure? What is cloud computing? It's not going to be like that. A lot of it is role-based and kind of application questions. So things like, you are an administrator at a company in Paris. They need to set up virtual machines because of COVID. How would you go about doing this? Or what machine series would you use? What networking would you use? So be prepared for the style of questions by looking through the mock exams. And I think that's really going to help you guys during the day. My final tip for you guys is to have a schedule. So try to have a learning schedule where you fit in the time for you to focus on learning for your certifications. I mean, it's okay if currently you're not working and if this is your main focus and you're not at school or anything like that, but if you are at school, you're working, you're doing other things, you're really going to have to keep a schedule to keep you on top of your learning and to keep you motivated. I think it's a bit too much to say that you're just going to learn and then just see how it goes. For me, I had a schedule of kind of doing a couple of hours a day, so I knew that if I'm doing 2 hours, that's enough, that's all I'm going to do. So it made it a little bit easier to study all of that information. So pull together a schedule that's going to work for you. There probably are going to be example ones online which can help as well. Of course, there are other certifications which I haven't mentioned in this video for cloud computing across AWS, Google and Azure, and even outside of those, right, there are other cloud providers, for example Oracle as well. So make sure that you really do your research, think about what role you'd like to do once you've kind of finished these certifications, or what role you're looking to move into, and there will definitely be something that's out there for you. I will pop a list of other kind of top certifications in cloud computing in the description below for you guys to check out. So that's it for today, guys. Thank you so much for watching today's video. As I said earlier, I'm hoping to continue with this cloud computing series if you guys are finding it useful. So please like the video, comment, DM me on Instagram to let me know, and of course subscribe to my YouTube channel, and I will see you at my next video. Bye.